So I promised myself I was going to limit my puns to three or less, so hold me to that. Earlier this week, Samsung finally announced the findings of what caused the Galaxy Note 7 to explode. Not only in the first case with the initial shipping units, but also in the second after the recall. So a few things to bear in mind before I get to that. Samsung did say that the Galaxy Note 8 is probably going to be delayed a little bit. They were planning on announcing it at Mobile World Congress, which is coming up in February. So expect that to come out a few months later, but also that the Note line will live on. It's not going to be changed into a S8 Pro or anything. We will have follow-ups to the Galaxy Note line. So it did not go out in a blaze, that's one, of glory. So here's the short version of what happened. If you didn't know, the Galaxy Note 7's incredible phone, probably the best phone that I had ever tested. In fact, I went out and bought one. The thing started smoking, in some cases caught fire. Samsung issued a recall of the phones and then sort of a mandatory recall. Had about a 2 to 3 weeks in between and started shipping units they said were fixed. Those two were plagued with similar issues. So here's what happened with the first batch of phones. Samsung was trying to cram a lot of components into the Note 7. In fact, it was rumored that the retina scanning wasn't supposed to be in the Note 7 at all. It was supposed to be debuted in the Galaxy S8. In order to make the Note 7 a huge success, they pushed in, which pushed components to get smaller and smaller and smaller. And obviously in Samsung's effort to try and make the batteries larger, they put in a larger battery than perhaps they should. First batch of batteries had a bit of a design flaw that made their electrodes prone to bending, and in some cases led to a breakdown in the separation between the positive and negative tabs. So that caused a short circuit. In some cases, these things just exploded. So that's the story with the Note 7. That's kind of the end of that chapter. It wasn't anything that we didn't expect. It was sort of everything that we anticipated. Too much and too little space caused the batteries to bend. Lithium ion cells tend to swell anyway, and there wasn't any room for them to do any of that. So a lot of things led to these batteries starting to smoke and explode. Hopefully Samsung has learned no lesson, which they claim they have, and the Galaxy S8 will come a little bit later, but will come free of problems and will be a smoking success. That was only two. For Samsung. So what do you guys think? That ends the story of the Note 7. The Note 7 was my favorite phone. I was ready to use that for a very long time. That coral blue was hot and I enjoyed it, and I'm done with puns. Thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed. Leave a comment down below. Till next time, I'm John Rettinger from Techno Buffalo.